First off, I wanted to get your reaction on the report that we just ran. President Marcos saying amending the charter of the NFA and making all the amendments to the RTL, rice tariffication law, will give the government enough leeway to control the prices of rice as they begin to go up. Your reaction, please.
Yes, we're quite pleased that the president sees the urgency of reviewing the effectiveness of the rice tariffication law. You know, the original intentions of that law, which was passed back in February of 2019, were basically two. Number one is to make rice more affordable to our consumers. And number two, to improve the productivity and incomes of our rice farmers. Based on our own studies, the RTL so far has failed on both major objectives. Number one, yung alam po natin nung just before the RTL took effect, there was this rice crisis in the middle part of 2018. Before the crisis hit us, the prices po of rice, nasa kwan po 38 pesos per kilo. It's now between 50 to 60 pesos per kilo. Yan po ay a 30 to 50% increase compared to the price of 38 in 2019. In the past few months alone, ang rice inflation po ay umakyat po ng by more than 20%.
Correct.
So clearly, hindi po nagtagumpay ang RTL with respect to making rice more affordable to our ordinary consumers. In the case po ng ating farmers' income, ang estimate po natin ay ang nawala po sa ating mga magsasaka, at least during the first 4 years of RTL, on a per hectare basis, was about 10,000 pesos per hectare. So kung ikaw yung nagtatanim ng 2 beses sa taon, ang nawala pong income mo ay 20,000 pesos. That's big for a typical rice farmer. And in terms of productivity, hindi naman talaga anong lumaki ang productivity levels po natin. Kaya talagang every year I notice from 90% self-sufficiency in rice, this was just before RTL, I think we are now down to 77% self-sufficiency. So clearly, again, the way the RCEF was spent and the way the programs were implemented, I think we're not properly undertaken.
All right. With regard, Secretary Montemayor, doon sa specific role ng NFA, no, na pinaliit nitong RTL, which is to maintain a rice buffer stock, I understand the FFF has already made recommendations to Congress, no, about amending the RTL. But with regard to NFA, marami po kasing divided sa issue na yon. Should the NFA go back to regulating our rice buffer stock or not, in your opinion?
I think with respect to the buffer stocking role of the NFA, kailangan pong ipagpatuloy po yan. Kasi kailangan naman talaga natin na meron tayong reserba na bigas para makapagbigay po tayo ng relief o ayuda sa mga biktima po ng kalamidad. And that is set, I think, by the NFA at 9-day supply. So I think that particular role or mandate should be kept. Now, with respect to, kasi meron pong mga ibang nagmumungkahi ngayon na ibalik daw yung pamimili po ng NFA ng bigas, not for buffer stocking, pero upang maibenta po yan sa abot-kayang halaga. Sa mga kababayan po natin na kailangan. I think that has to be carefully treated and acted upon. Kasi siguro kung magkakaroon po tayo ng direct subsidy po sa ating mga poor consumers, malamang mas maganda pong approach is targeted. Because, you know, previously, the cheaper NFA rice, let's say, 27 pesos before, and any consumer could buy it, whether you are in the middle class or you're in the poorest sector or even the upper classes, pare-pare pong pwedeng makabili at 27. I think it's better to limit any subsidy program for consumers to the neediest Filipinos Sila lang po makakatanggap. Halimbawa, pwede pong gamitin dyan food stamps. Tapos yun pong gagamitin ng mga may hawak ng food stamps para makabili po ng mas murang bigas po sa NFA. So I think if there will be any subsidy to be given for consumers, it has to be a targeted one.
Mr. Montemayor, you talked about the farmers' income decreasing by 10,000 pesos per hectare. Yet the tariffs were designed to be able to increase productivity and competitiveness of rice here in the Philippines. What do you think are the major flaws of the rice tariffication law, apart from the role of the NFA?
Well, yung una dyan, Gretchen, yung ano eh. Yung kasi ang isang malaking problema talaga under RTL, rice importation and business was open to the private sector. Government totally withdrew except for the buffer stocking of the NFA. So unfortunately, during the initial 4 years, grabe yung pagpasok ng kwan, imported rice. If I remember correctly, on a yearly basis kasi, dapat talaga inangkat lang natin mga 2 million metric tons of rice. Under RTL, nako, halos matudoble po yung ano, mapasok na imported rice. So much so, our country became the number one or number two top rice importing country in the world. So, siyempre, ang effect ng kwan, malaking volume po ng imported rice na pumapasok, lalo na kung mura ito, talagang babagsak yung presyo po ng palay. At sumabay pa naman yung pagpasok ng maraming bigas sa panahon po ng anihan. So sana po ginagamit ngayon ng tama. Meron naman po kasing provision sa batas, yung tinatawag na safeguard measures. Under that, government can impose additional tariffs in order to prevent or to discourage further imports from coming in. That was never used, despite the fact that it is a WTO, you know, compliant measures. So, yan po, hindi po nagkaroon na po ng karampatang protection ang ating mga magsasaka. With respect to the other components of the RCEF, maganda naman po yung idea na kwan, yung tariff collections or revenue from the importation of rice that goes into a fund. It's called the Rice Competitiveness Enhancement Fund or RCEF. And that RCEF is used now to provide modern farm equipment, provide good seeds, to provide training and credit to our rice farmers. Again, it was a good idea, but yung pong implementation po, marami pong problema. Kaya dapat pong ripasuin po kung paano mapapabuti po yung implementation po ng pondo sa ilalim po ng RCEF. And we are also suggesting na magdagdag po ng bagong item sa menu. For example, yung kailangan po siguro dito yung ipasok po yung solar-powered irrigation systems and water impounding, especially for rain-fed rice areas, so that we can withstand the effects of climate change, especially El Nino, much better. And then the whole idea of providing budgets also for post-harvest facilities. Ang laki kasi nang nawawala po sa ating production po ng palay at bigas from the waste stage alone. Di ba, pinatutuyo lang po yung palay sa mga national highways po natin. Yeah. Nawawala po dyan anywhere from 10 to 15% of our production, because of the lack of post-harvest facilities. Of course, lack of irrigation is also a major factor.
There's a lot of problems, definitely. And you're right, the law is well-meaning, but it's always it always comes down to the execution and the implementation. We're going to have to leave that there for tonight. Thanks so much for sharing your thoughts with us, Federation of Free Farmers Chairman Leonardo Montemayor.